Hey guys, I just want to be able to go over this video quickly to give you guys the case why the Green Bay Packers should keep Mason Crosby. I know there's a whole lot of people here that would probably say to just cut Mason Crosby because of all these missed field goals and stuff like that. People are very much down on Mason, and I am very concerned about him. And I know that I have said that in my past video that the Packers should consider moving on with JJ Molson, or possibly look into free agency to see if there is a kicker available that can do a better job. But now I'm here to go on the flip side on why the Packers should keep Mason Crosby. So I'm going to go over the stats for this season and what has transpired over, and I'll give you probably his worst game and his best game. I'd have to say probably here, this game against Minnesota was not his worst game. He did miss a chip shot field goal, so that's probably up there when it comes to his worst game. But he did nail a 54-yard field goal in that game, so that was good. And this game against the Kansas City Chiefs, where there was two field goal attempts, one field goal was missed and the other one was blocked. That was due to a trajectory issue, and the Chiefs just made a really good play on special teams to block the field goal. The game against the Arizona Cardinals, he made a 21-yard chip shot, and then Washington missed a field goal. The Chicago Bears n nailed all of his nailed nailed his single field goal from 39 yards out. And then the Cincinnati Bengals game is probably arguably the worst of the games, where he only got 57.1 field goal percentage made. It was also Evan McPherson of the Bengals missed some of his field goals too. He was 7 of 4 for field goals. And then coming down here against the Pittsburgh Steelers, he nailed all of his field goals. And then the 49er game, which is the game that has been the famous game where he nailed that clutch field goal to put the Packers up 30 to 28 against the 49ers at San Francisco at least. And then Mason made his 39-yard field goal, the only points in that game against the New Orleans Saints. So he has had a 65.2% of making his field goals. Now that is pretty darn good solid grounds for possibly cutting a kicker if he's only making just 65% of his field goals. And now here is the overall body of work of Mason Crosby ever since he became a Green Bay Packer and was drafted back in 2007. Now, we've seen this before where Mason has had a down year. 2012 comes to mind, where he has had it worse. He only made 63.6% of his field goals, and then the year next got 89.2%. So what I'm trying to make here is that, yes, he's having a really down year and everybody was saying cut Mason Crosby, but the year next he had a much better year. He did a really good job. Matt LaFleur was asked if the Packers were going to look into possibly bringing in a replacement. Matt LaFleur said absolutely not.
Matt, is there any plan at all right now to thinking about changing kickers?
Oh, that no. I would say absolutely not.
And now we know for certain that I think that Matt LaFleur has may has that Matt trusts Mason, and he could easily turn it around. So the point I'm trying to come across to you guys here is that Mason Crosby is not, when you take a look at the stats here, he is not a bad kicker. So there's a difference between a bad kicker missing most of his field goals than a good kicker missing field goals. So I'm here to tell you guys that this is why the Packers should keep Mason Crosby, is because of the fact that he is a good kicker. So there's still a whole lot of time for a good kicker like Mason Crosby to turn it around and be able to get and to be able to nail his field goals at a much better pace, get used to Steven Wuerdl, and get used to Corey Bojorquez holding for him. There's a lot of things that can be corrected over the duration of the rest of the or over the rest of the season. I have pretty much full confidence that the three that the that the that the that the trio of Steven, Corey, and Mason can get it together and be able to make some field goals, especially when it comes playoff time. That is really going to be where the unit is going to have to get it together for sure to be able to get us moving into the playoffs and potentially the Super Bowl. So that's what I have to say for this. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comments. And I just want to be able to assure you guys that Mason Crosby is a good kicker who's just having a down year, and there's still time for him to turn it around. So with that, I'll catch you guys later for another one. Go Pack, go.